When was the last time you were actually at a Supercross in the U.S. and what do you expect to see Saturday night?
Well, I live in Australia now. I live in WA, West Australia, and it's certainly a long way from here. The last time I was at a Supercross, I can't even remember. I mean, over there we've got Supercrosses as well, the Tennis Center, and Chuck Sun's been over in Australia as well, in Adelaide, Brisbane, and things, Melbourne. But it's as far as a Supercross like this, of this standard, and this category of riders and things, and the best riders in the world, I'll tell you, I can't remember. It's probably 1981, 82, something like that. It's been 30 plus years, and it's a long time ago. So I'm really looking forward to this Saturday night and see what these boys put on for a show and things. And yeah, we compared to what we used to have, and now there is no comparison. I mean, it's absolutely amazing what these guys do now. It's such a short-lived career. I mean, his career was short, mine was short, Pierre's is short. We all still ride. I mean, I still ride. I race within reason, not every weekend, but certainly a lot of weekends. Pierre still rides. Pierre's, I mean, 67 years old, and he's still riding every weekend. And that's a tribute, you know, all by itself. And I also think that these guys here, as the younger generation and the new generation, that it is a very short career to make the money that you can, to make the training aspect of it. I mean, it's, you look at everybody's career, and I think if you look at the stats, you'll find that it's probably only a 5 or 6 year career, 7 year career. I don't know anybody that's gone for 10 years and been champion for 10 years of some sort in the first, you know, in the first 4 or 5. So you guys pay attention to what Johnny says about training. Your health and being in shape, injury, make the best you can of it, because it is a short career and you guys don't quite see that. I don't believe anyway, and take the best you can of it.